Katrina, did you just take a deep breath?
No.
I just picked up like a scream, like a whisper scream.
No.
In your mic.
It was like my mic again.
It was like.
What?
It's always my mic.
There's something around you.
Shut the doors. Use the energy. Do something in here.
That was me breathing.
All right, this is what I'm getting, right? Just from an intuitive sense. There's like a chaotic male down here. Like very old school male. Very like, this is my place. This is my place. But there's something else. There's another level. And it's bigger than like the ritualistic stuff we know about. You have to be very careful when you go into a house thinking that it's a residual haunting or a spirit who's stuck there, and it will really throw you for a loop because it turns out to be something much more sinister.
Want to try running in the geo box?
Yeah.
I'm going to use our old geo box. Spirits can use this, can manipulate the words coming through radio frequency, EMF, electromagnetic fields, and vibrational waves, and they'll modulate that so we can have intelligent responses with whatever is here. What can you tell us about this room? Is there something evil here? What the fuck is going on? There's like major interference coming through.
Stop interfering with whoever is trying to come through. You have to let them talk. Who invited you here?
Satan was here. You hear that?
Who invited you here?
I thought it said Satan.
Oh, I can't keep my back there. Something's trying to attach itself to me.
You need to back off right now. You cannot attach yourself to any of us in this room. It just got really cold around me.
Careful, Katrina.
That was loud.
Was that your foot?
Holy.
Puddles of water with no reasonable cause are a classic sign of a malicious haunting. They are often the first indication of a poltergeist or demonic presence.
Look, there's a trail. Look, look. So it goes from here to here. Where do you go? But look, it curves.
What could this,
this
be?
Room. Look at this. Look at this. All right.
Where's it going?
Do you see it?
Yeah.
Look at this trail.
Where's it?
Here. It goes to the kitchen. It goes to the freaking kitchen. Look at this. Something keeps leading us back to that kitchen. And what's interesting is these pools of water seem to form right above the crawl space. So is there some sort of connection? What'd you say?
A shadow man standing right behind you. Right in there.
Are you trying to tell us something?
Right there, I saw it standing right there.
It's here. What is it? What are you?
We're here to try to help Eddie, who's the owner of the house. This is his house, and he wants it back. So whoever you are, whatever you are, you don't belong here. Do you understand me? Do you understand me?
Whoa! That came from the kitchen.
Oh, it's cold in here.
What the fuck is going on? The fuck is all these open for? Holy shit.
No way.
All this is open.
All the cabinet doors are open, and that's pretty amazing considering we were just in the kitchen 5 minutes ago. I'm blown away by this because this is something that physically can open these cabinet doors. I've seen this in human hauntings, I've seen this in non-human hauntings. So to me, right now, it's either something that is causing a little bit of mischief, trying to scare us, or maybe it's something that's trying to give us a message.
So this device was created by Steve Huff, Huff Paranormal. It's called the Portal. We're gonna run just a basic spirit box off of it. It's gonna be scanning radio frequencies. There we go. Is there anybody here?
We're only speaking to whoever's in this house or whatever's on this property. Nothing else is allowed to come through.
Hello?
Why do you keep leading us into the kitchen?
Katrina?
Yeah.
I'm gonna switch
it.
I'm plugging in this other device now. Who's here with us?
Me.
What is it about this kitchen? What are you trying to tell us with this kitchen?
Send help.
Send help.
What are you leading us to?
Please.
What are you leading us to?
Could this be the aggressive spirit that Michelle made contact with?
That bitch won't tell.
The ground is shaking. Do you feel that? Holy fuck. The house is shaking. Everybody get out. Come on, let's go. Get out of the house. Go, go.
You guys okay?
Did you feel the ground shaking?
I had just walked the perimeter. The ground shook like if there was an earthquake or something. I was standing like where I am from my van now.
Yeah.
The lights inside and outside came on and came off without me touching anything.
Did it scare you?
Freaked me out.